Good afternoon all. Today we have the concept of series of complex numbers. You have already learnt about sequences and series and power series in real numbers, the same concept. The sequence, series and power series in complex numbers you have to learn here. Here also the convergence of sequence is there, convergence of series is there and the Taylor series is there. All that you have to learn and some small problems connecting all these things. Let's move to the portions. Series of complex numbers. The first concept is convergence of sequence. An infinite sequence Z1, Z2, etc., Z3, etc., Zn, etc., that is sequence Zn of complex numbers. All these Zn's are complex numbers, has a limit Z if corresponding to any real epsilon greater than 0. There exists a positive integer n naught such that mod Zn minus Z less than epsilon whenever n greater than n naught. If a sequence Zn has a limit Z, then the limit sequence is said to be converges to Z, and we write limit n tends to infinity limit Zn equal to Z. If the sequence has no limit, then it diverges. Next, we have the theorem. Suppose that the same concept in real sequence, only difference is that here real part and imaginary part is there. Suppose that Zn equal to Xn plus Iyn, so the complex sequence, and Z equal to X plus Iy. Limit Zn tends to infinity Zn equal to Z, if and only if limit n tends to infinity Xn equal to X. Real part of sequence, real sequence part converges to real part of Z, and limit n tends to infinity Yn is equal to Y. Now we have a theorem, show that the sequence Zn where Zn equal to minus 2 plus I into minus 1 raised to n by n square, n equal to 1, 2, 3, etc. converges as minus 2. So to do this problem, here Xn is given that minus 2, the constant sequence, and it converges to, so the sequence is minus 2, minus 2, minus 2, etc. Xn equal to, so that sequence converges to minus 2 itself, and Yn is equal to this minus 1 raised to n by n square. Now we have to show that this converges to 0. Minus 1 raised to n square. In the real sequence, we can first we have to find an epsilon such that this find epsilon such that modulus of yn minus 1 raised to n by n square minus 0 less than epsilon whenever n greater than n naught, that type of n square. Or we have to find limit n tends to infinity minus 1 raised to n by n square is equal to 0, that we already know that limit n tends to infinity minus 1 raised to n by n square is equal to 0. So this its imaginary part converges to 0, so the sequence converges to minus 2. Next, convergence of a series. An infinite series sigma n equal to 1 to infinity Zn equal to Z1 plus Z2 plus etc. Zn of complex numbers converges to the sum S if the sequence Sn whose Sn equal to sigma n equal to 1 to n Zn equal to Z1 plus Z2 plus etc. Zn n equal to 1 to etc. of partial sums is converges to S. Like the same like the real series, if the sequence of partial sum convergence, then the series is converges. If the sequence Sn of partial sums has a limit S that is converges to S, we can write sigma n equal to 1 to infinity Zn equal to S. Now we have the theorem. Suppose that Zn equal to Xn plus Iyn, n equal to 1 to etc. and S equal to this is X plus Iy, not X equal to Iy. This is X plus Iy. Then sigma n equal to 1 to infinity Zn equal to S. If and only if sigma n equal to 1 to infinity Xn equal to X and sigma n equal to 1 to infinity Yn equal to Y. the real series part converges to x and the imaginary part of the series converges to y. Now the concept absolute convergence. Absolute convergence, a series sigma n equal to 1 to infinity Zn of complex numbers is called absolutely convergent if the series sigma n equal to 1 to infinity modulus of Zn, which is equal to sigma n equal to 1 to infinity modulus of xn plus iyn. Modulus of xn plus iyn is sigma n equal to 1 to infinity square root of xn square plus yn square of real numbers converges. So its absolute part converges, then it's called absolutely convergence, or the modulus converges. Now if the sequence Zn convergence but sigma n equal to 1 to infinity mod Zn diverges, that is it's not absolutely convergent, then the series sigma n equal to 1 to infinity Zn is called conditionally convergent. That also we have learnt in real series. Now the theorem is absolutely convergence of a series of complex numbers implies convergence of that series. That also we have learnt. Now next we have the theorem. Prove that the series sigma n equal to 0 to infinity 3 minus 4i raised to n by n factorial converges. Zn equal to, in the first problem we have Zn equal to minus 2 plus I into minus 1 raised to n by n square. Here xn is equal to minus 2 is a constant series. Constant sequence convergence to minus 2. And yn is equal to minus 1 raised to n by n square. And we can take the limit n tends to infinity minus 1 raised to n by n square is equal to 0. Therefore, yn converges to 0. Therefore, xn plus iyn converges to equal to zn converges to minus 2 plus I0 is, this is the first problem. Second problem is sigma n equal to 0 to infinity 3 minus 4i raised to n by n factorial. This series we have to show that it is converges. For that we have to take the absolute convergence. Consider 3 modulus of 3 minus 4i raised to n by n factorial, which is equal to the square root 3 minus 3 square plus 4 square minus 4 all square raised to n by n factorial, which is equal to 5, 3 square plus 5 square is 5 raised to n by n factorial. Now we have to show that this is converges. Now for that, this is, take this as un, an. Consider, let find the limit an plus 1 by n tends to infinity an plus 1 by an, which is equal to limit n tends to infinity an plus 1 is 5 raised to n plus 1 by n plus 1 factorial by 5 raised to n by n factorial. So this is 5 and this is n plus 1, which is equal to 0. Therefore, by ratio test, mod Zn converges. Therefore, series is absolutely convergent. Absolutely convergent. Therefore, series is convergent. Next concept is power series. An infinite series of complex numbers which are of the form sigma n equal to 0 to infinity n z minus z0 raised to n, which is equal to a1 plus a0 plus a1 into z minus z0 plus a2 into z minus z0 all square plus etc. an z minus z0 raised to n plus etc. where z0 and the coefficients n are the complex coefficients, and z may be any point on the stated region containing z naught is called a power series. Note, any analytic function can be expressed as a power series and is known as the Taylor series. You have already learned about Taylor series in sequences. Now this is the Taylor theorem. Suppose that a function f is analytic throughout an open disk mod z minus zn less than epsilon centered at z naught with radius r naught, then at each point z in this disk, f of z has the power series representation f of z equal to sigma n equal to 0 to infinity n into z minus z naught raised to n mod z minus z naught less than r naught, where n is equal to fn z naught by n factorial, n equal to 0, 1, 2, etc. The proof of the theorem is using Cauchy's integral formula and the extension of Cauchy's integral formula. Here we use the concept, we can expand in like a geometric series when it is mod z less than 1. That concept we are using, and the proof has been done. Now, note that the power series representation of f of z obtained in the above theorem is known as the Taylor series expansion of f of z about z naught. When z naught equal to 0, the above representation becomes f of z equal to f of 0 plus f dash 0 of z by 1 factorial plus f double dash 0 of 2 factorial plus etc. fn 0 by n factorial plus etc. The series is known as the Maclaurin series. Now we have 2-3 problems. First problem is obtain the Taylor series representation for 1 by z about z equal to 1, z equal to 2 and z equal to I. You have to find f of z, f dash z, f double dash z and the substitute in the Taylor series expression. And now next problem is Maclaurin series of e raised to z. Here also find f of z, f dash z, f double dash z and obtain the value at z equal to 0. In the fifth problem, show that when z not equal to 0, sin h z by z square. Here, for obtain the Maclaurin series for sin h z and after that divide that series by z square. Now we can do the problems. So our problem is find the Taylor series for f of z equal to 1 by z at z equal to 1, z equal to 2 and z equal to I. For that we have to find f dash z, f dash z equal to minus 1 by z square, f double dash z equal to minus 1 into minus 2 by z square or 2 factorial by z square. And f triple dash is equal to minus 1 into minus 2 into minus 3 by z raised to 4, which is equal to minus 3 factorial by z raised to 4. Now first we are evaluating at Taylor series at z equal to 1. So we are computing f of 1 equal to 1, f dash 1 equal to minus 1, f double dash 1 equal to 2 factorial, f triple dash 1 equal to minus 3 factorial. So by the expansion, f of z at z equal to 1 is f of z, which is equal to f of 1 plus z minus 1 by 1 factorial f dash 1, z minus 1 all square by 2 factorial f double dash 1 plus z minus 1 all cube by 3 factorial f triple dash 1 plus etc., which is equal to 1 plus z minus 1 into f dash 1 is minus 1, minus 1 plus z minus 1 all square by 2 factorial into 2 factorial, f double dash 1 is 2 factorial plus z minus 1 all cube by 3 factorial into f triple dash 1 is minus 3 factorial plus etc., which is equal to 1 minus z minus 1 plus z minus 1 all square minus z minus 1 all cube plus etc. Now we have to evaluate at z equal to 2. So we are evaluating f of 2, which is equal to 1 by 2, f dash 2 is minus 1 by 2 square, f double dash 2 is 2 factorial by 2 cube, f triple dash 2 is minus 3 factorial by 2 raised to 4. So f of z at z equal to 2 is f of 2 plus z minus 2 into f dash 2 by 1 factorial plus z minus 2 all cube by f into 2 f double dash 2 by 2 factorial plus etc., which is equal to 1 by 2 plus z minus 2 1 factorial by 1 factorial into minus 1 by 2 square plus 1 z minus 2 all square into 2 factorial by z cube by 2 factorial z minus 2 all cube by 3 factorial into minus 3 factorial by 2 raised to 4 plus etc. which is equal to 1 by 2 minus 1 by z square 1 by 2 square into z minus 2 plus z minus 2 all square by 2 cube minus 2 z minus 2 all cube by 2 raised to 4 plus etc. F of 1 is equal to 1 by a. Now we have to evaluate at z equal to I. So f of I equal to 1 by a, f dash I equal to minus 1 by I square, f double dash I equal to 2 factorial by I cube, f triple dash I equal to minus 3 factorial by I raised to 4. Now f of z at z equal to I is f of z which is equal to f of I plus z minus 1 into f dash I by 1 factorial z minus I all square by 2 factorial f double dash I plus f z minus I all cube by 3 factorial f triple dash I plus etc. which is equal to 1 by I plus z minus I into f dash I is minus 1 by I square plus z minus I all square by 2 factorial into f double dash I is 2 factorial by I cube plus z minus I all cube by 3 factorial into minus 3 by 3 factorial by I raised to 4 plus etc. which is equal to 1 by I minus z minus I by I square plus z minus I all square by 2 factorial minus z minus I all cube by I raised to 4 plus etc. Next problem is for the f of z equal to e raised to z, show that the Maclaurin series is sigma n equal to 0 to infinity z raised to n by n factorial. For that we have to evaluate f dash z. We know that the Maclaurin series is the Taylor series with at z equal to 0. So f of z is e raised to z, f double dash f dash z is e raised to z, f double dash z is e raised to z, etc. fn z is e raised to z. So f of 0 is e raised to 0 is 1, f dash 0 is 1, etc. fn 0 is 1. So we know that the Taylor series, the Maclaurin series is f of z is equal to f of 0 plus z by 1 factorial f dash 0 plus z square by 2 factorial f double dash 0 plus etc. plus z raised to n by n factorial f n 0 plus etc. This is the Maclaurin series and we know that f of 0 is 1. This is z by 1 factorial into 1. F dash 0 is 1, z square by 2 factorial into 1 plus etc. z raised to n by n factorial into 1 plus etc. which is equal to sigma n equal to 0 to infinity z raised to n by n factorial. Next we have to show that the sin h z by z square is equal to 1 by z plus sigma n equal to 0 to infinity z raised to 2n plus 1 by 2n plus 3 factorial when z not equal to 0. Since sin h z by z square is not analytic at z equal to 0, we have to find the Maclaurin series for sin h z first. For that f of z equal to sin h z, then f dash z equal to cos h z, f double dash z is equal to sin h z, f triple dash z again cos h z, f 4 z is sin h z, etc. So f of 0 equal to sin h 0 e raised to 0 minus e raised to minus 0 by 2. So this is 0, f dash 0 is e raised to z plus e raised to minus z by 2 cos h z. When z equal to 0, this value is 1, f double dash 0 is 1. 0, f triple dash 0 is 0. So f 4 0 is 0, alternatively 0s and 1s. So sin h z equal to f of 0 plus z by 1 factorial f dash 0 plus z square by 2 factorial f double dash 0 plus etc. which is equal to 0 plus z by 1 factorial into 1 plus z square by 2 factorial into 0 plus z cube by 3 factorial into 1 plus z raised to 4 factorial into 0 plus etc. which is equal to z by 1 factorial plus z cube by 3 factorial plus z raised to 5 by 5 factorial plus etc. Sigma which is equal to sigma n equal to 0 to infinity z raised to 2n plus 1 by 2n plus 1 factorial. Now when z not equal to 0, sin h z by z square is equal to 1 by z square into sigma n equal to 0 to infinity z raised to n plus 1 2n plus 1 by 2n plus 1 factorial, which is equal to 1 by z square into z plus z cube by 3 factorial plus z raised to 5 by 5 factorial plus etc. which is equal to 1 by z plus z by 3 factorial plus z cube by 5 factorial plus etc. which is equal to 1 by z plus sigma n equal to 0 to infinity z raised to 2n plus 1 by 2n plus 3 factorial.